Should I get a master's in clinical research? Hey guys, we've got a viewer submitted question on if they should get a master's in clinical research. We're going to talk about that after the intro. Stay tuned. Hey guys, ECRG here, back with another episode. Today I've got another viewer submitted question here. This is a YouTube viewer. But if you're listening on the podcast, you can also submit questions and I will cover them. You can email us eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com or you can comment down below if you're listening on YouTube. But we've got a pretty interesting question here. And this is a question I've gotten a number of times. And I might have even made a video on this before, but the nuances are a little bit different. And what this person is experiencing or what their experience is, you may be able to resonate a little bit more with. It may cater more to your situation. But if it doesn't, then you can always ask your own question, as I mentioned earlier. But before we get into this person's question, I just want to remind you guys, we do have the resume review program going on. You can email us at eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com for any inquiries you may have regarding that. But a lot of people are having a hard time getting into the clinical research industry. And a lot of that could be because of your resume. So I just want to make sure that you guys have your best resume forward. I mean, people are applying to jobs. It is more competitive than ever. With each passing year, it is more and more competitive to get into this industry as more people know about it. So you really want to make sure that your resume is in tip-top shape. And the best way to do that is to have me review it. I've been in multiple positions in clinical research. I know what it takes to get you into the clinical research field, period. So email us eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com if you're interested. So this person's question is, he says, hey, ECRG, I am an international medical student who will graduate with a degree of MBBS next year. That's the MD equivalent, the US MD equivalent. I am planning to do my internal medicine residency in the USA. And I have a spare year, and I was wondering if I should take up a master's in clinical research so that I can not only be a physician, but also a researcher. I would really appreciate your insight on this, since I do not have much idea other than information obtained from the websites. What should I expect out of such a program? And are they really worth the tuition fees that they charge? Your advice would be highly appreciated. And I really like your YouTube channel. Keep up the good work. So thank you for this subscriber who emailed in this question. This is a very, very good question. So I'm going to tackle each of the points you made one by one. So it is awesome, first of all, that you are going to be able to do your residency in USA, because that should mean that you're able to practice in the USA. So that is very good. And that also means you're going to have access to actual USA-based clinical research opportunities. So the easiest way, and I think the best way for you to get some experience in clinical research, is to be a sub-investigator. And this is something that residents do all the time. I literally see 1572s with like 20 or so doctors listed on them as sub-investigators. And that's usually going to be from an academic institution with a bunch of sub-investigators. So that's what that is. So it should be pretty easy for you to get involved in research as a sub-investigator. And that is what's most important. Sponsors really want to work with people that have experience in clinical research. So if you're interested in being a researcher, like you said, I'm assuming that's a principal investigator, a PI. If you're interested in being a PI, well, the best way to become a PI in the future is to be a sub-I when you get that opportunity. So when you're in residency, get as much research experience as you can. Be a sub-I on as many studies as you can. Get as many experience as you can. So that a few years later, when you're ready to be a PI, and you're applying for studies at your own practice or your own institution, and you're ready to be a PI, sponsors will select you because you have prior research experience. You're gonna understand ICH-GCP. You're gonna understand the research process. You're gonna understand PI oversight and PI oversight duties. So that's a really good opportunity. Not a lot of people get the opportunity to practice in residency in the USA. And this is, of course, gonna be really good for you if you want to do clinical research in the USA and practice medicine in the USA. So that's really awesome. So is the master's in clinical research really worth your while? I would say no, particularly because you already have an MD degree. So, or I guess an MBBS degree, which is the MD equivalent. I would say it's not something you should go after because once again, these programs are, they're businesses. They're meant to sell you this program. They're meant to sell you this degree saying that you're going to be able to make more money or it's going to do what you want. And that's not necessarily the case in this industry. This industry is very much reliant on experience. It's experience, experience, experience. So I would much rather you get the experience as a sub-I than get this master's in clinical research. That's going to go a lot further for you than that degree. That degree is going to, you know, teach you some of the book knowledge, but it's not going to teach you some of the knowledge that you need to actually conduct the research on a day in and day out basis. As a lot of you guys know, one thing that is in the book, and then when it comes to the actual practice of it, is completely different. So that's something you definitely want to think about. But I would not, if I was in your shoes, get the master's in clinical research. You can always get it later if you want to. I know people that have done it. Once again, I do not recommend it for many people to get the master's in clinical research because I don't see it increasing people's salaries. I do not see it really benefiting them other than taking a lot of time out of their personal lives to do the master's in clinical research. I would definitely more recommend some of the certifications like the CCRP, like the CCRA, like the ACRP. Those certifications I think are a little bit more popular. They're way more cost effective and they're probably more respected in the industry because of, you know, they just have a lot more respect than the master's in clinical research. This master's in clinical research and the ability to major in clinical research seems like a relatively new thing. Not a lot of universities have that option now. So it could change in the future. I mean, this is being recorded in 2018. So we will see what it's like in 2020 and 2021. But as of right now in 2018, it is not worth your while to get a master's. But as you can see, if there's more and more people getting into the industry, more and more competition, it could be beneficial for people that are new to get a master's in clinical research. So we'll see. I think people with experience will always win because right now sponsors want people with experience. So as long as you focus on your experience, getting that sub-I experience and really, you know, not just getting the sub-I experience and putting your name there and putting that on your resume, you want to make sure you're actually getting involved in the research. So whether it's, you know, doing some history and physical exams, whether it's, you know, even helping the PI with some oversight and their oversight duties, try and get involved there so you can kind of speak to it. Because in the future, you're going to have an SIV, you're going to have a site qualification visit from a CRA, and they're going to ask you a little bit about your experience with the research. So you really want to make sure that you've actually done it and have actually kind of worked on the research, not just put it on your resume. So that's something else to think about. And that's pretty much it with your question. Thank you so much for listening and submitting your question. I love answering these questions. They give me really good ideas for videos and also let me know what you guys are interested in hearing more about. So submit more questions, guys. I love these questions. And I typically do respond in however you do it, whether you text me or email me. I do respond that way, but I always typically, if it's a new one, I will make a more in-depth video to go along with it, video/podcast. So hope you guys enjoyed it. As always, guys, subscribe to the channel, subscribe on the podcast, write comments down below. I love that too. And email or give me a call, 910-502-3732. You can text me there too. All right, guys, take care.